I'm sure that by now we are all well aware of the forthcoming regulations, and in particularly those concerning the emissions such as the sulfur cap, the EDI, the MRV, and the greenhouse gases. In OCEANKING, we believe that the short and possibly longer term measures to tackle the environmental regulations and make shipping greener can be achieved by utilizing a combination of systems and technologies. This can be a combination on board the same vessel of an exhaust gas cleaning system or LNG, for example, a wind-assisted propulsion such as rotors or sails. If we have hull optimizations during early design stage of the vessel, and propulsion energy saving devices, which is the topic we will concentrate in this presentation. Wärtsilä has developed a wide portfolio of energy saving devices through their long experience and their LEAPS heritage. These devices can be a strong part of the solution as they increase the efficiency, but are also reliable and have a short payback period, factors which are also very important in today's increasingly competitive shipping environment. For example, we have a pre-swell stator here called the EnergoFlow. We have nozzle, the high-efficiency propeller cap, the EnergoProfin, and the EnergoPack, which is a solution combining propeller and rudder design together. We have fuel reduction through eco controls, and a newly development of the air lubrication. The pre-swell stator, the EnergoFlow Wärtsilä has developed, is an innovative, robust, and cost-effective device which increases fuel efficiency without increasing maintenance needs. It basically creates an optimal inflow for the propeller by guiding one side of the propeller flow in the opposite direction of the propeller rotation, generating pre-swirl. The solution consists of multiple curved fins entering attached to the side, which reduces the tip vortex and also levels out the peak stresses that occur in severe loading conditions such as slamming. This device is highly dependable on the ship's block coefficient and the propeller power loading. Here in the graph, we can see the correlation between power loading and power reduction, especially for vessels with higher block coefficient, such as bulkers or tankers. We can see fuel savings up to 10%, taking also into account propeller optimization. For faster vessels such as container ships, we can expect fuel savings in the region of 4%. In any case, we have seen a payback period of 1 to 2 years. This is a design on an EnergoFlow device, the pre-swell stator, on a 250,000 deadweight bulk carrier with an engine power of 20 megawatts and an estimated annual fuel consumption of 18,000 tons. This design was done in 2018 and taking a bunker index of $400 per ton, including installation costs, but not dry dock costs. This was not taking into account propeller optimization, but yet the efficiency improvement was calculated to be 7.3%. We therefore have a significant amount of fuel saved in an annual basis, coming up to 1,300 tons, which also is translated to reduction in emissions. We also have the high-efficient propeller cap, the EnergoProfin. This device improves the propulsive efficiency by weakening the propeller hub vortex. Partly, the energy losses of a propeller are related to losses around and after the propeller boss. The EPF weakens or eliminates the propeller hub vortex behind the propeller, hence manifesting itself as increased thrust. On average, we can see fuel savings of up to 2% and therefore relative emissions. And we also have reduction in vibrations by this device. And what's really interesting, we also have reduction of underwater noise, which are it's something we will see more regulated in the future. Even today, we can see a 23% reduction on Vancouver Harbor fees only by having such a device installed in your vessel. Finally, it also eliminates the rudder and horn cavitation damage, which is also something to be considered commercially. The EnergoPack is a high maneuverable and fuel efficient system, which is taking into consideration more in new building stage. It has been developed jointly by Wärtsilä on the propeller side and by Becker Marine System, which is a market leader for high performance maneuvering solutions. It's an integrated design with key benefits being the reduced fuel consumption and associated emissions, which can go up to 6%. We also have excellent noise and vibration behavior and best-in-class maneuverability. It is applied on all kinds of vessels, but it's more effective on vessels operating in speeds between 14 and 31 knots. It can be used for FPP, CPP propellers, for twin or single propulsion layouts, for ice-class vessels. It basically enables increased propeller efficiency due to the effective elimination of downstream flow losses. Another way to reduce fuel consumption is via smart controls. These have various functionalities as cruise control, fuel consumption limitation setting, and actual fuel consumption visibility on the bridge. We say we can achieve fuel savings up to 3%, and this is achieved by a smart control system that combines optimal propeller pitch with optimal engine loading. This is applied on four-stroke engines with CPP propellers, though. Finally, we have the new development of the air lubrication system. In this system, searing air is released from air release units in the hull to create a carpet of bubbles that coats the full flat bottom of the vessel. As a result, frictional resistance is reduced, reducing the fuel consumption and all the associated emissions. It has been developed by Silverstream Technologies and is being offered by Wärtsilä, giving customers the opportunity to utilize Wärtsilä's global service network. In the table here, we can see the expected system performance. We can see that the numbers vary. It depends highly. Actually, it's not easily predictable on the CFD calculations, but it has been proven in reality that the numbers are on the higher side. And we can see numbers in the region from 4 up to 11% fuel savings. Therefore, associated emissions are once again eliminated. Thank you very much.